Well, Kumail, so you're kind of at the start now of this whole Oscar campaign gauntlet. You excited to, I mean, everyone's already seen the movie, they love the movie, but now you get to talk about it for the next 3-4 months. So here we go.
Well, I will say what's cool is that when we first did all the press, it was as the movie was coming out, so we were talking to a lot of people who hadn't seen the movie. Mm-hmm. And so now the conversation's different. People have seen the movie, they know what it is, and so you can actually like talk about the movie in a way that you weren't able to. Since I've been doing interviews for this, they've all been sort of different conversations. It's been cool because when you're promoting a movie, people know what the description of it is, so the number of questions they can ask are like sort of limited because they haven't seen it. But now people have seen it and, you know, experienced it. What a douche. They've ingested the movie.
Yes.
And everybody has sort of a different line of questioning. People want to know different things about it.
Well, you're back shooting Silicon Valley at the same time, right? So
Is
it, what's it like now to balance this Oscar film world and going back and playing Dinesh?
I love it. Usually I go to work at like 6 a.m. I'm at work till like 7 p.m. and then I'll sort of do this kind of stuff. Sometimes talking about something you've already made for me is, it's just not creatively satisfying, you know what I mean? I love talking about the movie, and I love that we're invited to this and that people want to talk about the movie, but it's a different thing. It's a different kind of satisfying. It's not the kind of satisfying that you're like making something that's going to come out that people will see in a few months.
Yeah.
And so it's cool to be able to do both, to like work and make something that people will see in a few months, and then to also talk about something that we, you know, made a few months ago.
Yeah. Well, you can talk about that. You can talk about Silicon Valley, and then, of course, your SNL hosting from a couple of weeks ago. So this is the year of Kumail Nanjiani.
Oh, my God.
Are you taking it all in? Are you enjoying the year of Kumail?
I am truly enjoying it a lot. I am having a blast. It's been truly, truly, truly so wonderful. And I'm not just saying that, you know. Emily, my wife, who wrote The Big Sick with me, would say, you know, you don't like ever take a moment to like be happy with anything you've done. You're always thinking about the next thing. And that's sort of how I've been for many, many years. But this year I sort of decided that I would enjoy being done with something and I would enjoy people enjoying something I did. And that's kind of worked. I sort of convinced myself. So I'm having the best time. I mean, to make something that's that personal and then to have people like it, I mean, there's truly nothing better.
Well, you know, our tagline at IndieWire is the voice of creative independence, and that seems to be the epitome of being a creative independent, is telling your own story.
Yeah, it's, and you know, it's one of those things where you feel like, I don't know, is our story worth telling? I mean, we're just normal people, but I think everybody's story is worth telling, and I think sometimes when people are making movies or TV shows, they try and dilute it, or they try and guess what the audience wants, or they try and make it into a different kind of format that they think would make it more commercial or something. But the lesson that Emily and I have learned going through this is you can't really try and guess what the audience wants. Just like make something that you can be proud of, that is the story that you want to tell, and you just sort of have to trust that people will find it or not find it. But really the most important thing is to be proud of what you're doing.
And the sequel to The Big Sick is, of course, you and Emily writing The Big Sick.
It's this. This
yes.
is going to be
this,
the sequel.
This is part of the sequel.
Yeah. You're in right now. Yeah. I'm going to get this footage and use it.
It's ultra meta.
Yeah, it's tough, you know, because people are like, what are you going to do next? Is it going to be as personal? And I'm like, probably not. Probably do a couple things that are... You know, whenever you write, everything's autobiographical. Everything's personal. You want it to be, but I don't think the next thing will be as, like, obviously autobiographical. You know, Emily and I are sort of actually figuring out our next thing to write, and we're in the process of doing that, so I'm excited.
What's the pie in the sky dream? What's the thing you really want to do or hope someone approaches you to do?
We talk about this, you know, because our movie is very, very small, independent movie, but we love, like, I love big blockbusters. I love summer movies. I like small movies. I like all kinds of movies. So we've kind of been talking, like, what kind of thing do we want to do? Would we want to try and write something that's going to be a bigger studio thing, that's going to be a bigger budget, a bigger world, but then we'd probably lose some of that creative independence. Or do we want to write another movie that's sort of in this size and we really like get to make what we want to make? So that's what we're in the process of trying to figure out.
Yeah, like an indie superhero, sort of the best of both worlds.
You're probably kind of joking, but I do want to write an indie sci-fi movie. I have something I've been working on that I think would be fun.
Yeah, well, you are Mr. X-Files, so of course that makes sense.
Yeah,
so.
No, I love sci-fi and superheroes and horror. Emily and I have actually talked about doing something in horror together, but I think the next thing that I'm diving into writing that I just started working on is a sci-fi idea.
You can't tell us anything about X-Files next season, right?
I'm not in it. I can tell you that.
Yeah. You're too busy, or?
Did you watch my episode?
I did. I loved it.
Oh yeah, it was a great episode.
It was.
But you know, not really conducive to that character.
Yeah, well, and also again, it's meta considering how much you talk about the X-Files. It's sort of funny to actually see you on that show.
It's kind of tough, you know, because I did love the X-Files so much and started doing this podcast about it, and then ultimately I got to be on it. But being on it, I was like, oh, I guess I can't really do the podcast anymore because I sort of feel like I'm a little bit part of that world now. So listen, it's a dream come true, but people are like, when are you going to go back to the podcast? And I'm like, I don't know if I can go back.
Oh, so you walk through the looking glass and there's no going, oh, that's...
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't know if I mean, I still love the show. I still watch it, but you know, you know these people now. I know the writers and if there's an episode, you want to be able to talk about the episodes frankly, you know. I'm not like a PR person who's like promoting the show. I'm just talking about the show I love, and there are certain things that you know, I love the show, but there are certain storylines that you're like, hey, this one doesn't quite add up as much, and so I can't really do that, so I feel like, I don't know, I feel like I can't go back to it.